In the previous video, we have discussed the introductory part of queue data structure, right? In this video, we will see how actually we can implement queue. Queue can be implemented either using arrays or linked list, right? Or using stack also we can implement queue. So in this video, we will see basically how you can implement queue using arrays, right? So before going to the implementation part, you must check out the previous video. You can check out in this I button, right? What we have discussed, queue is a collection, or you can say it is a list where the insertion is possible from one end, and that end is known as rear, and deletion is possible from other end, and that end is known as front. This is how logically you can represent a queue. This is what front, this is what rear, right? You can insert data from rear end, and if you want to delete the data, then you can delete from front, right? And if you suppose consider here front and here rear, that is also fine. So insertion would be from rear and deletion would be from front, right? You can choose any option, fine, but you have to take care of the rule of insertion and deletion, fine. Now how we are going to actually implement this queue using arrays? Arrays means we will use static memory location. First of all, obviously we are going to specify the size, how much data we can store in this queue, right? The capacity of the queue. And while implementation of the queue, you have to take care of that rule, that is FIFO rule, because queue follows what? FIFO rule, first in, first out, that we have discussed in the previous video, right? So obviously we are implementing this queue using array, so you have to enforce this rule here. And the time complexity for NQ and DQ operation must be order of 1. See here, insertion is known as NQ and deletion is known as DQ operation in queue, right? These are more technical terms in context of queue. So we will use NQ and DQ. Now we actually implement this queue using arrays, fine. Now how to declare array like this, int array name and here size of the array, that is any constant, 5, 10, as you wish, 50, 100. Right, here I am taking the name Q because I am implementing Q, that is why I am taking the array name Q, and here obviously we will specify the size. Now how to write down the code? See, so now suppose in main function I am calling first of all NQ function 3 times. I am passing this 2 here, 5 and minus 1, means first of all I want to insert 2, then 5 and then minus 1, right? After that we will display the content of the queue. After that, peek function, peek operation, fine. Peek operation means it is going to tell you whatever the front value of the queue, right, without removing that value from the queue. Again, DQ function. DQ means it is going to delete the data from the front of the queue. Again, peek, and then we will display the content of the queue, right? Now first of all, obviously we are going to declare the size. We are using what? Static memory allocation here, fine, in array. You can use dynamic array also, and for dynamic memory allocation you can use linked list also, fine. But here I am using static memory allocation. So I have defined int, here the name is Q and size is n. See, this Q we will use in all the functions, that is why I am declaring it globally outside of main function and outside of all these functions after header file directly, right? And here I am not writing that size in constant term. I am using what? Macro definition, hash define n 5. So in program, wherever you will use n, then it will replace this n by this 5. Or here you can write hash define max size is 50, 100, like this, right? But if you declare this Q size within these functions, then you cannot write here the variable. Then you have to specify here the constant term, either 5, 10, 50, something like this, right? I am declaring globally, that is why I can write here n, fine. Now front and rear in queue, these are two important parts that we have discussed. So you have to take two variables, one is front, and we will initialize this front first of all with minus 1, and rear is equal to also minus 1 globally, because front and rear, both the variables we will use in each function. That is why I am declaring these variables globally, so that we can access these variables in each function rather than declaring those variables again and again in every function, right? And -1, -1 means Q is empty. We don't have anything. Now we are going to define this NQ function, right? How to write down the code. So here also, see, here I am passing value 2. So obviously you have to receive this value when you are going to define this function, right? Here I am calling this function. Fine. So now the data type of 2 is integer. So you have to take a int variable to receive this 2, right? So you can say this is the logical representation of this Q. Size is 5, n value is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is actually an array, but we are using this array for implementation of Q. So you can say here I'm using this array as a Q data structure, right? Both front and rear are pointing to -1 right now. Fine. Now see, first of all, you will check for the overflow condition. And what is that overflow condition we have discussed in the previous video? When rear becomes here, rear is pointing to here, 4 means this n minus 1, maximum size minus 1, because we will insert from the rear. When you will insert first element, then here it would be inserted, means rear plus plus, then again rear plus plus, rear plus plus, rear plus plus and rear plus plus plus. When rear is reached to here, maximum minus 1, it means we cannot insert any other data here, Q is full. So first of all, you will check for that thing, for overflow condition. Now here you will write if rear equal to n minus 1. It means here simply you can print printf overflow, or you can say printf Q is full, right? This thing we have discussed in detail in the previous video. You should check out that video first, right? Now this is not a case. So second case may be else if there is nothing in the queue, like this. If Q is empty, then both front and rear would point to -1. That is the condition we have considered for empty queue, right? So now else if front equal to -1 and rear equal to -1. In that case, Q is empty. Now what you will do, first we will insert here. So front would be increased as well as rear would be increased, both would be increased, right? Now both would point to 0. Now here simply you can do, first of all, front is equal to rear equal to 0, -1, after that it would be 0 after incrementing. So now you can insert here the data. So here what you will write, see, the name of array we have taken is q, and here you will write rear, because always we will insert from the rear. NQ would be from the rear part, is equal to whatever the value in x, right? Now third case may be else. See, first of all, NQ2 at starting Q is empty. If rear equal to n minus 1, that this condition is not true, but this condition is true. Front is -1, rear is -1. Yes, both are -1, right? Front and rear equal to 0 means front is pointing to here, rear is also pointing to here. Q of rear value is now 0. Q of 0 means here you will insert x. X value is what? 2. So now here I have inserted 2. Now third case may be Q is not empty, Q is not full. Q has some data, and after that I want to insert another data. In that case, what you will do? Suppose I have 1 in this Q, that is 2 I have inserted. Now I want to insert 5. In that case, what you will do? We will not touch this front, because we will always insert from the rear end. That is the rule of the Q, right? So now, first of all, rear plus plus. So here what you will do? Rear plus plus means rear is now pointing to here, 1. Now you can insert here the data. So Q, name is Q, Q of rear equal to x. That's it. See, you can check now. After inserting 2, both rear and front would be pointing to 0. Now again call NQ function, NQ 5, x now become 5. If rear equal to n minus 1, no, this condition is not true, because rear is 0, rear is not 4. This condition is also not true. Now control will go into else part. Rear plus plus means rear would be pointing to here now. Q of rear, Q of 1 is equal to x. Now here we can insert 5. Again call nq minus 1. This condition is not true because rear is still 1. This condition is also not true. Now rear plus plus. Now rear is pointing to here. Rear becomes now 2. Q of 2 is equal to x. Q of 2, here we will insert x. X value is minus 1. So this is the nq function. Now we will see the decoding for dq function. Right. Here I am writing this dq function. Nothing. We are, see, dq function, we are not passing anything, so I will not write anything here. Right. Here also some cases are there. First case is if this q is empty, in that case dq means, can we delete anything? No, we can't delete anything, right? So first you will check if front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1. This is the condition of empty q, right? In that case, here simply you can print what? List is empty, or you can say underflow condition. Now, else if when both front and rear are pointing to the same index, this thing also we have discussed clearly in detail in the previous video. So you should check out that video first of all. Suppose I have called dq function two times, and dq means I have deleted this, I have deleted this. After deleting these two, front would point to here and rear is also pointing to here. Means both front and rear are 2. It means there is only one element in the queue. So here if front equal to rear, it means there is only one element, and after deleting this element, this queue will be empty, right? So here what you will write, you will set both front and rear equal to minus 1. Because this is the condition we have taken for empty queue, for showing the empty queue. Front is equal to minus 1, rear equal to minus 1, right? So that's it. Now, third case may be this case. Q is not empty and there is more than one element in the queue. In that case, what you will do? Suppose we have three elements in the queue. Now, simply you will do what? Front plus plus. Here I can write front plus plus. Because dq operation can be performed on the end that is front. We can delete data from the front only. That is the rule of the queue. You have to take care of these rules, right? Because we are implementing here queue. So you have to enforce these rules here, right? So front plus plus. Front plus plus means now front is pointing to here, right? Now this is what a garbage value. Means we don't care what garbage value lies here in this cell, because suppose in future you will access this cell, then you can overwrite this value. The queue is basically from front to rear, means this is now the queue. So this is now a garbage value for us. You can delete it, right? Simply you have to do front plus plus and that's it. And if you want to print the dequeued element, you want to check out what element you have dequeued, then before doing front plus plus, here you can write printf, the dequeued element from the queue is percentage %d. I am writing only this thing because I don't have space. So here you can print first of all this data. So how you will access this data? Name of this is queue of this front. Because before updating this front was pointing here. Queue of front means queue of 0. This would print 2, and after that you can do front plus plus. And that's it. Now suppose again after this dq, again I am calling dq, right? Again control will go here. Front equal to minus 1, rear equal to minus 1. No, this condition is not true because front is 1, rear is 2. So control will not enter here in this loop. Else if front equal to rear. No, this condition is also not true because front is 1, rear is 2. So control will go in else part. Printf, the dequeued element is q front. Q front is 5. So it will print 5. After that front plus plus means after that front becomes here 2, front would point to here. Now again suppose third time you are calling q function, in that case what would happen? See, now see, this is the garbage value. Front and rear are pointing to here, so the q is only between front and rear. So this is only the q. Now these are garbage value, means we have deleted these values, right? We don't care what values lies here. Now This condition is not true. This condition is true now. Front equal to rear. Front is 2 and rear is also 2. as you can see, right? So it means we have only one element, and as you can see, we have only one element left in the queue. So front and rear equal to minus 1. We will both set these front and rear equal to minus 1. Both will point here. It means this is also now garbage value. We don't have anything in the queue, right? So this is how we are going to enqueue and dequeue the data. Now we will see the coding for display and peak function. Now, at some point of time in queue, I have 2, 5 and minus 1, right? After these enqueue function, now I want to display this data, whatever the value in the queue. So now I will define the display function. First of all, you will check if the queue is empty. In that case, obviously, there is nothing to display in the queue. So what is that condition? You will write if front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1. In that case, here you will print what? Queue is empty, right? Else, now we will print this data. See, every time I use while loop, when you are traversing the list or anything, or you are displaying the content, but someone asked me why all the YouTubers use while loop. So in this video, I'll use for loop. Fine. So I'll display using for loop. So for that case, else, now, obviously you have to take a variable I. So you have to declare that variable I here in the display function, right? Otherwise it will give you error. Now, first of all, I is equal to front, from where I will display the content, that is 2, 5 and minus 1. So first of all, I should point to here. I is equal to front. Front is 0, so I is also 0, right? Now, we will move this I and print the data till here, right? Till here I want to print the data. Once I reach to 3, then I will stop. So here you can write, I'll print the data till I less than rear plus 1, that is rear is 2, rear plus 1, that is 3. Till then I will do I plus plus, and here I will print that data. So here simply write printf percentage d and q in subscript I will write I, right? Here in else part you can write the q is, and after that you can print. Fine. Now see the working of this for loop. This is not the case, so control will go into else part. For I is equal to front. Front is 0, I is also 0. I less than rear plus 1, rear plus 1 is 3. Yes, condition is true, so control will go into this loop. Percentage D, Q of I. Q of I means Q of 0. 2 would be printed, right? I plus plus. Now I becomes 1. I is pointing to here now. I is containing value 1. 1 less than rear plus 1, that is 3. Yes, control will go enter into this loop again. Q of 1 would be printed. Q of 1 is 5. 5 would be printed. Again, I plus plus. Now I becomes 2. So here is I now. I is 2. 2 less than rear plus 1. Rear plus 1 is 3. Yes, condition is true. Again, printf Q of 2, that is minus 1, would be printed. I plus plus. Now I becomes 3. So I is here now. 3 less than 3. No, condition is not true. So we are not going to enter into this loop. Now exit from this loop. Right, so the output is 2, 5 and minus 1, right? So this is what our display function. Now the peak function, how you will write that coding? This is very simple. We are just checking what the value here at the front of the queue, what is that value, right? Without removing that value. In peak also you can write down this condition for checking the empty queue, right? I guess you can write down this condition. I'm not writing this. In else part, what you will write? Now if condition, now the queue is not empty, in that case you have to print that data, fine, the data at the front. So simply you will print here, write printf percentage d. You can write the data at front is then percentage d, and here you will write q and front in subscript you will write front. In this case, this condition is not true because Q is not empty. Suppose I am taking this case. Else, printf percentage dq front. Q is 0 means Q of 0 would be printed. That is 2 would be printed. Right? And that's it. The front of Q is what? 2 only. Right? Now, and this display function would 2, 5 and minus 1 would display 2, 5, minus 1. Then dq function. If you will print the data, then it would print 2. After that, if you will call this peak, then it would print 5, because after 1 dq, the front would be pointing to here, front plus plus. And now q is this one, and the front of q is 5. So now this would display 5. Display function would display 5 and minus 1, 5 and minus 1. So this is how we can implement a queue using arrays, right? But here the problem is, the drawback is, suppose the case is I have called nq function 5 times. Suppose I have nq'd here 0 and here 7. After that I have dequeued, I have called the dequeued function 3 times, 1, 2 and 3. So this I have deleted. Rear would be pointing to here and front would be pointing to here. Now suppose this is a queue at some point of time, right? And I want to insert some another data. I called nq function again. In that case, it would show you queue is full. Why so? Because see, condition is what? Rear is equal to 4, means rear is maximum size minus 1. And that we have discussed, that is condition of what? Queue is full. It will show you queue is full, but still we have space. Now we have 3 cells left. So this is what wastage of space. We cannot insert data here. Although we have space, but we cannot insert here. Now, what if you modify your coding something like that? If there is some space, then what? After this 4, again, if you do some increment in this rear, obviously we will not do rear plus plus, we will modify that thing. So this would give you 0. And we can insert here. After that, here also we can insert, right? So this is what a circular type of thing, right? After here, again, 0. If Q is empty, if there is still some space, in that case, you can do this thing, right? So this is what a circular queue. In this case, everything would be same. Just you have to update a little bit in your NQ function and DQ function. You cannot simply do front plus plus in DQ and rear plus plus in NQ. You have to modify that thing a little bit, right? Rather than rear plus plus, what you will do? Rear plus 1 mod n. N means size of this one, that is 5. Now in this case, see, rear is 4, right? 4 plus 1 mod n value is 5, that is 5 mod 5 is 0. And now we are getting rear is what? Not 5, we are getting rear 0. And this space is free. We can override this garbage value, we can insert here the data, right? Same for front also, you will do front plus 1 mod n. This thing we will discuss in detail when we will discuss circular queue. Fine. This is just an overview of that circular queue. This is how you can overcome that drawback of this queue. So now in next video, we will see how to implement a queue using linked list. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.